Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this quick tip, we're going to take a look at something special in EPS files. So I've got this EPS file here, and just to show you that I'm not using different EPS files, so this is where the folder is. It's on my desktop. Okay, let's take this and drag it over the Illustrator icon to open it. And you see here, those are typical RGB colors. And this is an RGB file, as you can see up here. So these colors will not look the same in CMYK. So they are not reproducible in CMYK. Now let's take a look at something else. I'm going to create a new file. Because EPS files, of course, you cannot only open them, you can also place them. So let's take a look at this here. I'm going to use this document preset, which is an RGB preset. It's a web preset. And you see here we have RGB color, and I'm going to create it up here, RGB color. So let's place this EPS file. I'm going to File and Place, and you see this is the folder, same folder on my desktop. And let's select this. No special options. I'm just going to link it and place it. And this happens. Now, these are not the same colors. You see here and here, both are RGB files. I've used the same EPS. So what's going on here? I'm going into this file again. This is the original file that I have saved as an EPS. So I'm not going to discuss the matter of EPS in here. In some cases, you might still need to save them. Most of the time, if you need to save them as RGB files, that is because stock companies ask for that, for whatever reason, and then you need to save them as an EPS. So let's go to File, Save As. I'm going to save it into the same folder. Let's just change the name. This is an EPS. And then let's go into the options. And the stock companies most of the time ask you for Illustrator 10 EPS. And all of these options from version 8 to version 2020 EPS means that actually you are not just saving one file, but you are saving two files into one sort of container. And that means there is an EPS part and there is an AI part, which is here, this Illustrator. That is actually an AI file inside of that EPS. And in these options here, you are saying what should happen in that EPS part of that file. And this is the dangerous option. Include CMY PostScript in RGB files, which means that the EPS part of your file is actually a CMYK file. And only the AI part of your file is an RGB file. And when you are just opening that EPS, then you are actually opening the AI part. While when you are placing it in your file, then you are using the EPS part, which is the CMYK part. Let's uncheck this so we are not including CMY PostScript, and let's go to OK. And this tells me, well, I'm saving it down, so I have selected Illustrator 10, which is, of course, a lower version, and this happens to older version things, and you are converting type and whatnot, and you are doing even worse things to other functionality that you have used. And this is an important warning, so do not turn it off. And let's go to OK. And then I'm going to that untitled RGB again. And let's just go to File, Place, and select the second one. And now you see we've got the actual RGB color while this is CMYK. So that's why that happens. So should you experience that, then now you need what to do. You need to open the file again and save it again, and then when saving, turn off that option. But if you are opening that file anyway, then maybe just use it. So only when you are giving that EPS part to someone else, then you need to be careful with that option.